Hello everybody, and welcome back to The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, the last episode. Excuse me, my name is Leon Eilerson, and for the MyDragon316 channel, welcome back. In the last episode, we made it all the way here to Kakariko Village from this entrance here. And it looks like now, well, let's see where it takes us. Ouch.
Traveler, I'm sorry, but I seem to have twisted my ankle. Let's see here. I'm sorry you had to see me like that. Say, traveler, where did you get that object hanging from your waist?
It's kind of a long story, but...
Yes, I see. That Sheikah Slate is a symbol. It means you are the hero of legend. Though there are few who know of such legends anymore. But we Sheikah have been waiting for you for a very long time. Please, before all else, I must insist that you meet with our leader, Lady Impa.
Alright, where is she?
Lady Impa's house is below Lantern Falls, just over there.
Oh, wow. Ted center of the town. Alright.
In any case, it was a real honor to meet you. I suppose you're used to that. Having lived as long as you have.
Not really. Shrine detector's going off. What is it? Where is it? Yeah, there's an apple tree there. Don't jump off. Okay. Link. Ooh. There we go. Ooh. Oh god. Whoops. Oh my, I really like how these houses are built. I really do. If only we can make houses like this in real life. That'd be one hell of a house. Only question is, who would be, who'd want to live in one of these places? That's the question probably nobody would have the answer to. Oh! Hello! The Talonne Shrine. Alright, let's head on in and see what it has to offer. Let's take a look in here. What do we got? Eightfold Blade. Okay. I'll gladly hold on to that. And what do we have over here? Oh, hang on a moment. I got a feeling this might be a shield, so drop one of these. Shield of the Mind's Eye. Okay. Let's swap to a two-hander. Here we go. Ugh. Basically tutorial mode on the Flurry Rushes.
Hmm.
Okay, if I'm just gonna waste this, let's use one of the other stuff. Come on, dude, what you got? Oh, too early. There it is. And we got our first Guardian Sword of the game. Nice. Alright. Let's see, what do we got in here? Output. Okay. Well, before anything else, I'm gonna have to run all the way back over here. Really? Just to drop. Oh. Or never mind. Let's hop on out of this shrine. Alright. There's a fourth spirit orb of a new heart container. Or something else. Right on down into the village. Ooh. 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 Ah, damn.
Yeah.
That guy's looking alright. New goddess statue. Cool. Let's go with the heart container. Good God. I say that and we're already in a village. Good God. Alright. There we go. Nice.
Aha! You found me! Here's another seed! Bye bye!
Alright. Let's.
You there! Who are you? How dare you trespass upon Lady Impossible?
Hmm?
Is that a Sheikah Slate? But that would mean you are. No, it's not possible. Can it be?
Please forgive us. Please forgive us for behaving so rudely. Of course, Lady Imp. Of course, we have heard the legends of hands from Lady Imp herself. Please, friend, go ahead and step inside.
Alright, let's see who. Head on up and see. They. Yeah.
A man! Is that? It's a Sheikah slate. Could you be the hero of, oh, my grandmother told me about? What was his name? It's not that I forgot. I'm just bad at speaking. As for me, my name is my name is Paya. I got it out. I know I should be able to say it easily, seeing as it's my own name at all. I'm so sorry.
That's alright, Alan.
Anyway, my grandmother's been waiting your return ever since I was little. Please hurry inside.
Alright. One thing I want to take off, as well as a few others. I don't mean to be nitpicky about this, guys, but in we go.
What is the matter? You are looking at me as though I am a stranger to you. Those eyes, they lack the light of familiarity. It is I, courageous one, Impa. Surely you must at least remember the name Impa.
Oh.
I see. So you have lost your memory. Well, it matters not. In fact, that may actually be a blessing in disguise, at least for the time being. Dearest Link, please come a bit closer. A 100 years ago. Yes, 100 years ago, the kingdom of Hyrule was destroyed. After you fell, Princess Zelda's final wish was to place you in a sacred slumber. And then, all alone, she went to face Ganon. Before Princess Zelda went to nobly meet her fate, she entrusted me with some words she wished to say to you. I have been waiting 100 years to deliver the princess's message. However, these words, which the princess risked her life to leave you, can't speak. Well, if you are to hear them, you must be prepared to risk your life as well. But I'm afraid that burden may be too much to bear. Here, while you are still without your memories, I leave the choice to you. When you feel you are ready to receive the princess's message, return to me. Alright. How about now? The words the princess risked her life to impart to you, I cannot pass them on to someone who lacks conviction. Are you prepared to risk your life for the greater good?
Hell yeah.
Not a memory to your name, yet you are as intent as ever to charge forward with only courage and justice on your side. You have not changed a bit. Once a hero, always a hero. Very well. Since you have lost your memory, I will recount for you all that has happened.
Here we go.
Also the history of Calamity Ganon, a endured over the ages. This evil has been turned back time and time again by a warrior wielding the soul of a hero and a princess who carries the blood of the goddess. With the passage of time, each conflict with Ganon faded into legend. So listen closely as I tell you of this legend that occurred 10,000 years ago. Hyrule was then blossoming as a highly advanced civilization. Even the most powerful monsters posed little threat to the denizens of the realm. The people thought it wise to utilize their technological prowess to ensure the safety of the land should Calamity Ganon ever return. Divine beasts were piloted by four individuals of exceptional skill from across the land, and thus the plan to neutralize Ganon was forged. Upon Ganon's inevitable return to Hyrule, the princess and the hero fought alongside these four champions against this ancient evil. The guardians were tasked with protecting the hero as the divine beasts unleashed a furious attack upon their terrible foe. Darkness delivered his final blow. The princess used her sacred power to seal away Calamity Ganon.
Years ago, in preparation for the foretold revival of Ganon, we strove to follow the lead of our ancestors of that of 10,000 years prior. But in the end, despite our best efforts and careful planning, we underestimated his power. In order to avoid ever making that grave mistake again, the princess left you these words. Free the four divine beasts. That is what she said. Divine beasts? The four divine beasts are the ancient Sheikah weapons wielded by four champions who Ganon defeated. The divine beast Varadhania, controlled by Daruk of the Goron. Divine Beast Va-Medu, controlled by Revali of the Rito. Divine Beast Va-Ruta, controlled by Mipha of the Zora. And Divine Beast Va-Naboris, controlled by Urbosa of the Gerudo. It would be extremely ill-advised to face Ganon without the power of the Divine Beast to help you. We must infiltrate the divine beasts that were stolen away by Ganon 100 years ago and bring them back to our side. More of the information about these divine beasts can be found by locating the four races scattered across Hyrule. The Sheikah Slate will guide you on your way. You must go where it tells you to meet with each leader there. It seems to me that your Sheikah Slate is not yet complete. The device Princess Zelda left you is your guide and also your memory. Now let's see. Someone at the research lab in Hatino Village might be able to help you. I seen the sign Hatino Village last episode, but... Oh, there it is. The location shining on the eastern edge is Hatino Village. It's a small village. One of the very few places that avoided suffering significant damage during the Great Calamity. You are Princess Zelda's only hope, in Hyrule's as well. You cannot turn back now. Follow your heart and seize your destiny! Alright. Impa hitting his heart with the reality. But I guess now, while we got time, I suppose we could go walk around the village, see what everybody has in store. However, I think there's something useful over and down this pathway here. Let's take a look, see. I feel like there's something on the other side of that tree. Let's go take a look,
so shall we?
Oh, hello. There's a shrine all the way over there. Oh. Damn, I scared away a few beetles. Oh. Huh. Oh. Fresh sledgehammer? Thank you, idiot. Yeah, one and two. Alright. Change to that and change to that. Don't see many other shrines.
Wow.
That is ridiculous. That is a ridiculously big, volcano. I'm not gonna lie. Look at it. Oh my god. Alright, let's head back into the village before we get too overwhelmed. Only thing. Anything else? That was fun to look at, is staring us right in the face. We'll get you one day, you asshole. One day. Alright, back into the village. Let's take a wander about and see if we can't... if anyone has anything for us. Let's see. Let's head over here. Oh. It looks like he's having... Oh, here we go. How did this happen?
Sir Link.
My Kukos.
My precious Kukos. They haven't come home yet. Now that my wife wants nothing to do with me, my Kukos. Those are my only emotional support. Whoa, what do I do?
Chill out, dude. I'll go find them.
Really? Thank you. Thank you so much. I have 10 Kukos total. Hopefully you'll be able to find them all.
Well, let's see. How many do we got in here? I count 3 so far. Yep, only 3. Oh. Oh god. Now we gotta go on a hunt for 7 Kukos. Oh god.
Oh my god, these guys are so freaking loud. Let's see if I can tell from here. Oh, almost. And alright. So that's 4. See if we can't find. So now we just need to find 6 more. Oh, hello, fireflies. There's another 4 fireflies? Yeah, that brings me up to 11. Sick. Wait, that. What? What? How did you get up there? How? I don't know. I have no clue what this game is playing at. Oh my lord, these things are so noisy! I know I have a mute button on my TV, but I'd rather not turn it on. I know all TVs have a mute button, but in all honesty, it's not really worth it. Oh god. Alright. So we got 5 Kukos down. So we got 2 Kukos down, giving him a grand total of, oh! God damn it! I hate it when that shit happens. What do we got here? Oh, do we have a sneaky river snails? That weren't sneaky. Stuck out like a damn sore thumb. Oh, hello. You will be number 6, if I remember correctly. And can remember how to do simple maths. There we go. Alright, 6 down. I say 6 down. 3 down. 4 to go. Alright, here's number 7. There we go. An iron shroom. Okay. Alright, let's get you in there. So that's a total of 7. And let me do a head count. So there's 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. So noisy. Are they not? Probably not a wise idea to head this way. Here's another one. So this ought to be 8 out of 10. Die. Alright, so we got 2 left to find. I already know that one. Oh, there's one right up there. Alright. Up you climb, Link. There we go. Right into the pen. Nice. So there's 9. Where in the world is... What? How in the hell did you get all the way up there? Up past your bedtime? Yeah, no kidding. It's like 3:20 in the morning. It's like half after 3 in the morning, dude. Alright. Now let's, now for the last one, let's simply glide on down. And got him.
Recently, the Jaeger clan has been acting suspiciously. It is our duty to protect Lady Impa. But more importantly, Link, I can hear the sound of my cuckoo flap. The cuckoo flapping its little wings. Could it be?
Yep.
I knew it! That faint yet lovely flapping of wings, that musical clucking. Ah, truly the epitome of joy. I'm so eager to get back home. Oh, Link, I'm so happy everyone is safe. Thank you so much. I'm afraid this isn't much, but please take it. With my thanks.
50 rupees, hey, I'll take it.
I'm ready to head out there again. Though I do wish my wife could come back to me. Just like my cuckoos did.
That's alright, dude. That's alright.
Let's see. This is the inn.
It's a shop there. And I think this is also a shop as well.
Yeah.
I can't remember the last time we had a customer in here. Young folks in this village don't want to have to you. Have much use for a bow? It's a thrill to see a young lad like you come into the shop. Well, don't mind me. Take your time looking around.
Let's pull out one of these. See if she changes her tone.
That's right. I could. Oh man, I knew. The moment I saw you. I had you figured for one heck of an archer. And I'm head over heels for a fine slice of man that can use a bow. So how about it? Why not
my brain just melted.
Why not take out that bow and show me something special?
You get it.
I like your attitude. All you gotta do is light the torches by the goddess statue. Think you're up for it? For the challenge?
You get it.
The thought of a young hunk drawing such flying a bow just makes my day.
Oh god. Arrows of burning heat. Okay. This should be easy enough.
To swap out to this one. And come on.
There we go.
Hey, kid. I saw you. You were amazing. Boy, what a shot in the heart that was. My husband's a fine archer himself, but we're living apart right now. This feeling, it's been so long. I'm so excited right now. That really was something special to see. In fact, here, a token of my thanks.
20 rupees. Okay. If only my husband hadn't become so obsessed with cuckoos and he kept up with his archery skills. If only. Okay. I think we just found a couple in the village. Oh my god, a couple with some problems, unfortunately. Okay. Let's swap all the way back to you. Let's bring out you. And... yep. There we go. Who are you? Hmm? Are you? Sorry to bother you, but are you a fellow traveler? As for me, I just love art. In fact, I'm traveling the world in search of beautiful landscapes. Just between you and me, I hear there's a great fairy fountain somewhere near this village. I hear it's breathtakingly beautiful. Aesthetics aside, they also say the place can bestow some kind of mysterious power on people. However, since I am an outsider, I can't get anyone to tell me any more or details than that. These villagers never leave the safety of their village, so travelers like me are treated with suspicion. But I won't give up. Oh, and if I manage to find anything out, I'll be sure to let you know. Right. Oh, man. Speaking of said great fairy fountain, let's see if we can't find it. That.
How did you get out of your pen? How?
For the Lord of Hylia, stay down in your pen. Sure you will. Let's see. Is there anything down here? Oh my god. That thing appeared out of nowhere.
Two more over here.
Get some more of this. Come on. Come on.
Come on. Come on. Come on.
Come on, we're too high right now.
Yes. Come on, that's three. All I need is you. I need you. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Almost there.
Oh my god, we just got four fairies, guys. Holy crap. That was pretty darn cool. Alright. Got a lot of blue nightshade and Endura carrots. Okay. And what do we got over here? Ooh, hello. Silent Princess. Ooh, hello. And if we gather enough of those, we could probably get enough to make a bouquet for Zelda.
Boy. Boy. Sweet boy. Please listen to my story.
Sure.
I am the great fairy Corterra. This place was once a beautiful spring. But as time passed, fewer and fewer travelers arrived to offer me rupees. As a result, my power has abandoned me. I'm nearly powerless now, so I beg your help. I need rupees to become whole again. All I need is 100 rupees. Once my power has been restored, I can help you do great things, boy. Now, if you have rupees, hand them over to me, quickly. Order to her for me to regain my power. I need 100 rupees.
There you go. Boop.
Thank you. You are too kind.
Oh my god. Here we go.
Fresh air after an eternity of decay. It's just so intoxicating. Thanks to you, I've been returned to my former glory. And as they say, one good turn deserves another. I can help you, boy. Allow me to enhance your clothing. It's the least I can do, but I will need the necessary materials. With the power available to me, I should be able to enhance your clothing a little bit.
Alright, let's see. Trousers and bandana. Let's go with bandana first. Yes, please.
Alright, let me do my thing.
Alright.
All finished. Just a bit stronger now. Oh, you've heard about set bonuses, right? How a set of clothes, those that have all been enhanced twice, could have a bonus. But only if you wear the whole set. Well, and not all sets have a bonus. Do you want me to enhance any of you? Any more of you?
I
can't speak. Do you want me to enhance any of your other clothes?
Sure, why not? Let's just get it out of the way. Yes, please.
Alright, let me do my thing.
Alright.
I thought I would improve some of your other clothes for you, but it looks like that's not possible right now. Please come back here once you get some clothes or more materials, or once you've restored the power of my sisters. See you later.
Oh god. Okay. I think it's time to head back. First, let's get everything back. There we go. And let's head on back. Just head on back. Okay. Alright, guys. Now that we know what we gotta do, and now that we got... Now that we gotta fight. And now that we know we gotta go all the way here. Where is it? All the way over here. I think this would be a perfect time to come. Alright, guys. And you know what? Let's finish in the same spot we started. Why not? Anyways, guys. Because why not? Oh god, you guys, I'm having a lot of fun with this series. Because I hope you guys are too. Well, be sure to leave a thumb. Be sure to hit that like button as well as leave a comment on these videos if you haven't already. And if you haven't already, subscribe to the channel. Well, if you haven't. And until next time, guys. And as for where we're going in the next episode, guys, it's pretty obvious. But until then, guys. But until then, guys, I will see you next time. And bye-bye.